Okay, guys, so today we're going to be talking about the Swamp Knight. Is he good? Oh, yeah! Oh, my God, I love these new characters. Oh, my God. I mean, just look at him, bro. Look at that! Oh, he's so cool. So cool. All right, so, guys, we are going to cover everything Swamp King today. We're going to showcase the rockin' build that I came up with. And how I managed to utilize the full power of his weapons and his build and the support squad that I came up with and just how I just crushed absolutely everything. This guy is amazing. All right, guys. If you love the content that we do here, if you love our videos, please use our supporter creator code. It really helps us. It really helps us to keep doing what we're doing and keep on making these videos. So thank you so much for the support, guys. Thank you. All right, let's get right into it. Swamp King. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, this guy, man. This is a ring wraith right here. He's a freak. This guy's insane. Look at this guy's skills, man. Shockwave, of which I use all the time. Best hero ability in the entire game, hands down. This thing just wrecks everything. Anything that you lack in AoE, you make up for with Shockwave, like boom, instantaneously. Warcry is fantastic, but I didn't even need it for this whole video, honestly. I was gonna use the Warcry, but I was like, man, it just there was no opportunity that I felt like I needed it. I was so strong just across the board that you know, I was just like, it just never came up. I was like, yeah, I was gonna use it, and then I didn't. It's like whatever. And this is amazing. That's just a testament to the power of this character and how much more he has to offer. I didn't even use the Warcry. I could have been 45% stronger with 20% faster melee attack speed for 12 seconds. Didn't even need it. Going commando? Oh man, you don't really need this ability on this character because it's like, why? I mean, you could use it if you want to save ammo. But you're melee, so like, does it matter? Not really. I mean, you can use it against a mini boss if you want, but like, this guy is going to do more damage than his abilities. Like, going commando is like pretty much irrelevant. So I wouldn't even worry about that, because I mean, look at this guy. Look at this. This is the commander perk, man. The commander perk is just wildly powerful. Increases damage versus miss monsters by up to 42% based on the percentage of your missing health. The more damage you get, the more damage you do to the biggest, baddest enemies that need you to do more damage, right? Like, he does more damage to the people that need to get killed. Everything else is gonna get slaughtered. You're gonna eat through like small enemies like they're nothing. But when you fight the mist monsters, that's when you need that power, man. You need it, right? You need to smash them into dust, and this guy gets it done. 42%. As long as you're crippled, man, you're just a walking war machine of death. You can't be stopped. 42%? Are you kidding me, bro? Are you kidding me? And that's not even the half of it. This guy, in addition, taking damage whenever you get, like, every 1.5 seconds, this can trigger. You get hit. There's a 45% chance that you're going to conjure a phantasm that's just going to target a nearby enemy and go, boom! Take a bunch of damage, you and everybody standing around you. You're like, what? Seriously? Yes, seriously. This is a thing. You get basically two commander perks in one. This is just nuts, man. Phantasm is awesome. This is a trigger that will trigger all the time. You're going to be taking damage all the time. That's the whole point of this character, is to get injured, to get crippled. He's designed to be hurt. He's like, please hit me. Hit me so I can kill you in one shot, please. Yeah. Oh, man. This guy is nuts, bro. He's nuts. Now, look at this. This is how we turn this guy into just a murder machine. We took Blast from the past because of course we did. It's amazing. It's a Blast from the past, bro. Oh man, removes all of your shields and increases your max health by 200%. Mega tank instantly. hundreds and hundreds of thousands. You'd be pushing close to a million health of this guy. It's just crazy town. So you take that million health and you activate it with two dino heroes. We're going to use Prehistoric Izza and Paleo Luna. Izza gives you 33 more armor. And Paleo Luna, she gives you more damage based on how much health you have. So she kind of counteracts the fact that this character doesn't do as much damage when he's really, really healthy, right? When he has all his health, he's missing all his bonuses, all his critical bonuses. She kind of balances that out because she gives you damage based on how much health you have. So if you're maxed out on, 700,000, a million health, you're going to get some mega, mega damage bonus. She takes 5.5% of that current health and adds it as melee weapon damage. Disgusting. So you got that balance. You got the high-end damage, and then once you lose your health, Paleo Luna, her bonus goes away, and you start amping up all of your crazy, crazy, near-death perks. So here's some of those near-death perks we're talking about right here. We got From the Depths, and we got Monster Smash. From the Depths is our buddy over here, Merkin, Mr. Mermonster Ken. He gives you an extra 44% damage based on, of course, how damaged you are. So if you're crippled, 44% bonus damage. Yeah. Right? It's crazy. This is even better. This is better than his. His is cool because his damage, it's 42% against mist monsters. You could use this with a gun if you wanted. It just so happens I was like, nah. You know what I'd rather do? I would rather combo his ability with Merkin's ability and get over it's like, what was that? 86%? Yeah, 86%. Look at that. 44 plus 42, 86% bonus damage against mist monsters. Just wow. Just wow. Then we've got Monster Smash. This is Arlene Izza. She gives you all that lovely life leech. So this is how you stay alive, right? This is how you get to cripple. You get crippled. You're at the verge of death, and you stay alive using her. The closer you get to death, the more life leech you get, up to 15% when you're crippled. So once you're critical, that 15% life leech is gonna just keep on generating health, and it's gonna keep you alive. It's gonna keep you able to just keep on smashing and smashing and smashing. Quite often, she'll take you out of your critical zone, and that's when Paleo Luna kind of builds up a little bit. And it's just this perfect combination because you're gonna be taking damage all the time, just all the time, constantly triggering your phantasm and just nuking people down left, right, and center. And then you got her just fueling the phantasm over and over again. And when you get really, really, really hurt, you've got this just insane god level damage. You're just dropping one shot kill bombs on everything. Just total absolute annihilation. And of course, we're going to strap this guy with anatomy lessons. White Elf Fiona gives you an extra 15 crit rate on your swords. And yeah, of course. Crit rate, man. Just amp it up, right? Take all that melee damage, amp it with crit. You're going to be rocking probably close to 50% crit rate on your weapon and just absolutely murking everything. This guy is crazy. Now, the weapons that I used on him, it might surprise you a little bit, or maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe you already seen it coming, but oh my god, man. The Spectral Blade, of course, is amazing, right? Just amazing. It's a staple. It's so good. When you're at full health, nothing is going to touch the damage of the Spectral Blade. But being that I am purposely trying to get murdered and get injured all the time, I found myself just putting the Spectral Blade away. I use the Spectral Blade quite a bit, but then I was like, you know what? Why? Why? This guy's not about that jam, man. He's not about that noise. He wants bring the pain. Bring the pain! And that's when the Black Blade comes to town, man. Black Blade, dude, this guy right here, this is it, right? This is what you want in your life. You want a weapon that synergizes with being injured. This one can give you up to 80% bonus damage based on the percentage of your missing health. It's just insane. It's exactly what we're doing. It's the whole, the fundamental you know, foundation of this build. Be crippled, hit people, one shot, kill everything. Just, if you crit, they die. If you crit, they die. And the crazy thing is, if you crit, you will get so much health that you'll, like, you'll heal right up, and then you'll have to get crippled again. Because every time that you are crippled and you have 80% bonus health plus 40 or 80% bonus damage plus 44% bonus damage plus 42% bonus damage, if you crit, you're going to hit so hard that 15% regeneration is just going to, like, whoop, you're full. You're just like, it'll take you up past 50% like that, like, so fast. It's just crazy. Like, it's just crazy. You are going to be having problems getting injured and staying injured because you're going to hit so hard. You're going to crit so hard. You're going to heal yourself for more life than you can take damage on. The only way you die is if you get smashed by some ungodly level of burst, like a bunch of blasters targeting you at once, or like a multi-taker charge, you know, something really hit, like, hefty to take you down. Because otherwise, man, this build is just, oh man, the damage is so sick. It is so good. Oh man, it's so good. Oh, this is fun. The thematic of running around with that black metal blade flying through the air with your crazy, crazy, ludicrous, like, jumping attacks, just slamming into the enemy, crit killing everything, and then just knocking everything on the floor and then executing them. Just like, I wish there was a stab into the ground, execute, just, just like, execute, because you're basically doing it. You're just like, chop dead, finish them all off. Oh my god. You guys are going to have so much fun. God, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, guys, because I had so much fun making this one and using this character. I hope it was a lot of fun for you guys. I had a blast. Huh. All right, guys, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Leave a thumbs up. Please, please hit that little bell for notifications. And as always, leave a comment down below and let me know what video you want to see next. I'm always listening. I'm always reading. And I can't wait to make some more content for you guys. Thank you so much for all the love, man. Thank you for being a part of the VASH Corps. I love you guys, man. Thank you for loving on me and loving on Save the World and just holding this community together for this wonderful, awesome game. Oh my God, I love making videos for you guys so much. I love this job. Thank you so much, guys. And I will see you guys in the next one. Oh yeah! Ha 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 ha.